Hello students, in today's lecture we'll be looking at serial communication using the PIC-18 series of microcontroller. Communication is an important part of any microcontroller system. Exchange of data is required between different systems for the smooth and effective functioning of any applications. Now let us look at first, what are the different ways of exchange of data? Now let us compare between the two ways of transferring of data. The first method is the parallel method, and this is a very popular method. The parallel method is where exchange of data happens simultaneously on a number of lines, digital lines. So data A or system A will transfer to system B, or system B will transfer to system A the data through multiple signal paths, right? So all these paths will transfer data simultaneously from A to B or from B to A. In the case of serial, you may have only one line or two lines for transferring of data. That is, the data will be sent bit by bit from system A to system B, and from system B to system A on another line to transfer from B to A. So it will be sent single bit by bit. So in the case of serial, you will have transfer of data bit by bit, and in the case of parallel, you can have multiple set of bits depending upon how many number of lines you have. So you can have from 8, 4, 8 or more than 8 lines of data. Now the problem with parallel is you can have only short distances, otherwise there will be a distortion or there is a corruption of data. In the case of serial, it generally has two lines, the third line may be ground. Then you can have long distance in the case of serial. Third is that it is comparatively slower, where this is faster, so you can have more data moving in. Since it is parallel, you will have more data moving in, this is slower. Now the fourth part is that it is, depending upon the parallel, is expensive, since you have multiple lines that is required, so you will have more number of wires, more number of lines, so the expense is more. Serial is comparatively cheaper. Now in the case of serial, you have two methods of communication, something called as asynchronous communication, which we'll be looking now, and the other one is called as synchronous communication. Now in the case of asynchronous communication, you will be sending byte by byte, the data will be sent byte by byte, and when it is synchronous communication, a block of data will be sent, a multiple number of bytes of data will be sent in the case of synchronous communication. In the serial communication that we'll be looking in this lecture today, we'll be looking at asynchronous communication. Now before we jump into that, there is one more method in the synchronous asynchronous communication, called as the half duplex method and the full duplex method. In the half duplex method, there is only one line, say from A to B, and we have, let us take system C and D. So here A to B is half duplex and C to D is full duplex. Why A to B is called as half duplex is there is a single line. So if A has to transmit to B and B has to transmit to A, first A will transmit to B, and then only B can transmit to A, since there is only one line to transmit the data. So at one point of time, one will be a listener or a receiver and other will be a transmitter, and then after it is, then they have to exchange their roles. In the case of a full duplex, you can send as well as receive data at one point of time, since we have two lines. So one line can be used for transmitting and the other can be used for receiving the data, right? So both can happen together. So as you can see, full duplex has a good property that you can send as well as receive the data together. So comparatively, the transfer or exchange of data between the two systems will be faster compared to a half duplex method. Now let us look in the asynchronous mode a frame. Now let us look at only one transmission. So one is only sending, one system is sending, A is sending data to B. So here A is a transmitter and B is a receiver. Now when you send the data has to be received with a data integrity. That is, whatever data is sent by A should be received properly in the proper format by B. To do that, we have something called as a frame. So what does happens in a frame is, there is always a start bit and a stop bit, and between this data we can have from 8 bit to 9 bits of data, or even less than that, so 7, 8, 9 bits of data. So if you see over here, the start bit is a low signal, so it's a low signal. So a low signal will indicate a start bit, and a high signal will indicate a stop bit. The after the low signal, you can send, depending upon how much bits of data you are sending, of say 7, 8, 9 bits of data will be sent, and finally the stop bit will be sent. So here this is called as a frame. Okay, so this is called as a frame. So if I want to send an 8 bit data, 8 plus 1 start bit plus 1 stop bit, right? So I have to send 1 start bit, 1 stop bit, and 8 bits of data. In total I have to send 10 bits in a frame for a perfect receive of the 8 bit data. Now let us look at the timing. So here there is asynchronous is based on time. So each bit has some time, or this exists for some amount of time. Now that is sometimes called as bits per second. How many bits or how many signals are generated per seconds, and this is called as bits per second. In this case of serial, and in this particular case of serial, it is also can be called as baud rate. But in the modern context, baud rates gives an another definition, is the signal change per second. Signal change per second. Okay, so in modern technology you can have multiple number of signal change, or multiple number of bits sent per signal change. But in this case of serial communication, you will have only one bit per signal change. So the BPS and baud rate can be interchangeably used in this case, right? Now the timing between the bits, between these bits, is set by this baud rate, or by set by this BPS. Now in the case of PIC 18 supports asynchronous as well as synchronous baud rate generation, and the baud rate here is generated by an internal timer. So this is a timer, so it specific timer dedicated for this baud rate generation is there, and that is controlled by this SP serial port baud rate generator. Now to desire, if we want to generate any baud rate, the calculation is given like this. Baud rate is equal to F oscillator divided by 64 into X plus 1, where X is any value in the SPBRG or the serial port baud rate generator. So baud rates are generally standardized. So we have 1200, 4800, 9600, 19200, 38800, so on and so forth. Every double of that are the general standardized baud rate. So if you want to generate say 9600, let us assume I have a 4 megahertz oscillator, say 4 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 64 x plus 1. So I can do this calculation over here, right? And you can get this x is equal to, you can get this value over here, 9600 into 64 into 4 into 10 raised to 6 minus 1, right? So this is the calculation that you will get, and you can do this calculation and you will arrive at this value. This value which should be loaded onto the SPRG should be valued, and this value should be loaded onto the serial port baud rate to get your desired baud rate. So the desired baud rate will be generated by this value that I am creating in the, or loading into the SPBRG. Now let us look at the registers related to the serial port. So let us look at the transmit registers. Here the clock source in the asynchronous mode is off. So we are looking at the asynchronous mode. So the clock source will be zero. It is of no use in the asynchronous mode. Now depending upon, you are having 8 bit, 9 bit. So if I have configured my serial port for 9 bits of data, the 9th bit of the data will be stored in this particular bit. T TXEN is to enable transmit or disable transmit. So I can enable as well as disable this transmit. Sync is for synchronous mode. Here, since we have done asynchronous mode, this will be 0. This is always 0. BRGH is you can have a high baud rate or a low baud rate generation, right? So here, as we can see that we have 64, this is called as a quadrupler, because in the previous case of the baud rate, we had f oscillator divided by 64 into x plus 1. Now if this is equal to 0, this is the condition for 0. Now if I make this 1, then this becomes f oscillator by 16 into x plus 1. So this is kind of a quadrupler. So whatever baud rate you have generated or you have calculated previously, it will be multiplied by 4 in this case. So if I make this 1, so whatever calculation you have done over there, so for that particular baud rate, that baud rate will get multiplied by 4. So for 9600 will become 38,800, right? So this is what will this bit will do. TRMT is when it is your TSR shift register, that is if this will 1, no transmission is going on. If this is 0, that means transmission is going on. Please don't write anything into the transmit register. Now this is the TX 9 bit register where the 9th bit data will be stored. The 9th bit data of the data will be stored over here. This TX9, so this TX9 is used to enable the 9th bit, and TX9D is used for this. TX9D is used to save the 9th bit. Okay, if I send any data, TXIF is used to say that the transmit has been done or it is empty. So if this is 1, that means it shows you the transmission has been done successfully. So TXIF will be set when the transmission has been done successfully. Now this is part of the PIR register. In the same way, we have register to receive the data. Now serial SPEN has to be made 1 to enable the serial port. If I make it 0, this will disable the serial port and the pins related to it, that is RX and TX. So there are two pins related to the serial port, RX and TX. This pin will become digital IO ports, and if I make it 0, SPN is equal to 1, then this RX and TX will be activated and these pins will become a reception and a transmission pins. RXN is to enable the receive the 9th pin. If I want to receive the 9th pin, I will enable this. Serial SN is single receive enable bit, and this is not used in the asynchronous mode, so this has to be made 0. Continuous receive, so I can enable continuous receive, so continuously I can go on receiving this bit. If I make it 1, right? ADNN is address delete enable bit. Okay, so if it is used with the 9 bit, so it is used in a multi microprocessor mode, we will not be looking at this, so we'll assume it is to be 0. Now if there is any framing error, if there is any problem with receiving the start and stop bit, this particular bit will be wired 1. There is the second error is the overrun error, and finally this is RxDN9 which will receive the 9th bit, so it will store the 9th bit over here. Now when I receive a data, when I receive a 8 bit, 9 bit, depending upon what you have configured, if you receive that data, then this RXIF will be set. So this will be set when I have received this data. Now where do we receive this data? This is received in the register called as RCREG, okay, receive register. So RCREG, and the transmit register is called as TXREG. So if I want to write to the serial port, I have to write to this register, and if I receive something from the serial port, I have to read from this register. So this has to be read from the register, and this is a write register, right? So this is how you can send or receive the registers from the send or receive the data from the serial port. Now the data that is to be sent is sent in an ASCII format. So the ASCII format is a simple format where the numbers are decoded as, or the numbers are formatted in the name of numbers. So if I want to send A, right, I just need to send the number 65. If I want to send B, I need to send the number 66, right? So if I want to say, I want to send this character PIC using communication, ASCII communication, I cannot send directly the letters. So instead of that, find out what is the number P. So I have to send 80, then I have to send 73, and I have to send the number 67. So first I will send 80, 73 and 67. That is how I can send the ASCII character PIC onto the serial port. So this is the format, this is a standardized format that is used in serial communication. So in summary, what we have learned? We have learned the difference between parallel communication and serial communication, the difference between half duplex and full duplex. Then we have seen the difference between asynchronous mode and synchronous mode. Then we have seen that to configure, it's a frame of 10 bit is sent with a start, 8 bits of data and a stop bit. Then we have looked at the baud rate. Baud rate is in this case, right now in this case, called as bits per second. So this is now generated in the PIC18 using called as the SPBRG or the serial port baud rate generator. The equation gives is baud rate. The baud rate can be generated. Baud rate is equal to F oscillator by 64 into x plus 1 if SPBRG. So there is a bit called as SBRGH. If BRGH is equal to 0 and if it is equal to 1, then this will be multiplied by 4. So this becomes F oscillator 16 into x plus 1, right? If this is 1. So if BRGH is equal to 1. So this is the same equation becomes F oscillator divided by 16 into x plus 4 or a quadrupler, okay, multiplied by 4. Then the TX register will control the TX STA, that is the transmit status will control the transmit register, and the RC STA will control the receives register. Then we have TX REG, where we are writing the to the TX REG will send the data, and to receive the data we need to read the RC REG. So with this we have completed or the understanding of the serial communication using PIC18 microcontroller. Thank you.